Guys, today I'm going to be replacing the RAM of my Acer Aspire 3680, and I'm replacing the RAM because the old RAM that came by default and stopped functioning and does not the computer is not booting. So now we are going to remove the RAM and replace it with a new one. So first of all, before proceeding, as you can see, we have to pull the locks in opposite directions, and then we have to pull the battery out. We have to remove the battery because if we don't remove the battery, and there can be electrocution or chances of short circuiting. So after we have removed the battery, we are going to open, there are two, as you can see, there are two compartments. One which is for the hard drive, and if you have to add an SSD or upgrade your hard drive, you have to remove the hard drive that came by default as there is no other slot for it. And the second compartment that you can see is where the RAM and the processor is. So now we are going to open it. So as you can see, guys, now I've removed the lid, and as you can see, this the RAM is here. There are two slots for the RAM, the upper one and the lower one. So first of all, this is the RAM which came by default. Now I'm going to replace it with the newer RAM since this one is not working. So you have to pull the locks apart, and then a clicking sound will be heard, and then you can pull the RAM out. As you can see, now once you have pulled the now that I have pulled the RAM out, I'm going to take the new RAM that I have ordered. It is a Hynix RAM. As you can see, it is a Hynix RAM, and I'm going to add it. So once you put the RAM into place, and a clicking sound will be heard, this will make us know that the RAM is in place. As you can see, now that I have put the RAM in, now I'm going to screw the lid back on. And then we are going to check if the RAM is working or not by opening it in the control panel. So after you have screwed the lid on, and we are now going to add back the battery. So remember, you have to pull the locks back out in order for the battery to go in. So now that the battery is in place, we are going to check if the RAM is working or not by opening it in the control panel. So I have checked that the RAM is working fine in the control panel system about setting. So and the little laptop is functioning smoothly and is booting up. So thanks for watching, guys, and remember to like and subscribe for more technology and reviews. Thank you.